watching Democratically Speaking. Mark Linde, your host, the chair of the Brockton Democratic City Committee. I'm here with Adius Pierre, a candidate for Councillor-At-Large. Welcome, Adius.
Thank you, Mark.
Nice to see you. Nice to see you in the race. I'm getting all our good Democratic friends on TV so you can talk about your candidacy.
Thank you very much. I'm very happy to be here to talk to my voters, and it's a pleasure to be with you as well, man.
Well, let me tell you, you're one of the friendliest people I've met in Brockton.
Thank you.
And let's talk about you. Tell people who you are, those that don't know you. I know you as very active in the Haitian community, but in the community in general. But tell us the Adius story.
Okay. Adius Pierre, I'm a resident of Brockton for more than 20 years. I'm involved in so many nonprofit organizations. You can say SHROOP, HCP, which is I'm the co-founder and vice president. And was a constable for the city of Brockton for more than 6 years. Mm-hmm. I have a background in law enforcement. Now I'm working for the sheriff department. I'm a family father and also a Christian. Mm-hmm. That means I believe in God. So I went to college. I graduated with a degree with criminal justice. Mm-hmm. I've been working in the community for years. And I was a volunteer for the Brockton Police Department for about 8 years to do interpreter for people who don't speak English and Spanish. Mm-hmm. Because I speak English, French, Creole, and some Spanish. So
you're going to teach me, right?
Yes, I will.
We're going to have classes at Haitian Community Partners, right?
Yes, I will. And I'm also a Democrat. So I love my city. I'm here to serve my city. So I'm not somebody who just came to Brockton. I see the good and the bad for about 22 years.
Now, when I met up with you the day of the Cape Verdean Festival, you were at the festival with your family.
That's great.
Tell us about your family, and it was nice to see young people supporting their father, their family member, for office, because a lot of young people don't get involved in politics, but you had your whole family with you. Talk about your family a little bit.
Thank you very much. And not only in politics, anything you're doing in general, if you don't have the support of your family, you don't have nobody. Your primary support should be at home. So I'm very lucky to have my wife and my children my side. I have 2 boys, 2 girls. So I'm a proud married man and a proud father. I cannot ask for more. Mm-hmm. So they support me every step in the way. No matter what I'm doing, they're always behind me. After God, it's them. Then other people come.
Now, Adius, were you born in Haiti?
Yes, I was born in Haiti.
Okay, and when did you come to this country?
In 1994. Mm-hmm. 1994.
And Brockton has a nice, large Haitian population. How did you come to Brockton?
Maybe that's something God has that I didn't know about it. Because the first city in America I came when I come to America is Brockton. And I've been living in Brockton since.
Okay.
So my family is there, my mother, my father, my sister, my cousin, you name it. Everybody's here in Brockton. My kids went still in school in Brockton, public school. Mm-hmm. My 2 sons just left George School to go to West Junior High.
Okay.
My daughter graduated from Brockton High. So I'm a Brocktonian. You can call me a Brocktonian.
There you go.
Yes, I'm Haitian, but you know what? This is my home.
Well. And now you want to give back.
That's correct.
You've served in different capacities, and now you want to serve as a councillor at large, citywide.
That's correct.
So what convinced you to get into the race? Why did you decide to run citywide on your first campaign?
Yes. Mark, one thing I realize, I don't want to be part of people who are always complaining about the issues, the problem that Brockton is facing. I wanted to be part of the solution. That's why I decided to get in the race. And when there is no way I'm running at large, so everybody can have a chance to vote for me, because everybody in Brockton, maybe people who would love me to be there as a city councillor, if they don't live in my ward, they will not have the opportunity to vote for me. Mm-hmm. Therefore, I go at large because I don't think I don't have any problem with people who go as a ward. That's their choice. But my choice is to serve the whole population of Brockton because I know my people live everywhere in Brockton. And when I become a city councillor, I will serve everybody in Brockton. So I don't want to feel sorry. Oh my God, you don't live in my. If you somebody come to me, Adius, can you help me do that? Wow, you don't live in my world. I cannot help you see certain things. I want to be a servant for every Brocktonian in general.
Mm-hmm. Now, your slogan is, I think it's a very good slogan, the change we need, the voice we deserve. Okay?
That is correct.
It's always, I ran for office. I used commitment to community. That's what I used
yes.
when I ran for state rep. Why do you think we need change?
Brockton is a city of diversity. It's already the same group of people over and over who are doing politics. I think we need change. And to get change, you need new faces, new blood, mm-hmm. to bring new idea. That's why we need change. When I become a councillor, I'm going to work with my colleague and with any mayor to implement what is working and to change what is not working.
Mm-hmm.
So myself, I represent the change that people need. And I am the voice for them, and I will be the voice for them. Because people who are voiceless, they need somebody to speak for them. They need someone to advocate for them. That's why I am the voice for the voiceless people.
Do you think this is an extension of what you've done by being involved with both SHOOP and Haitian Community Partners? Is this the next logical step?
Yes. You know why? Because, like you said, Sawish for Haitian Unity for Progress, Haitian Community Partners, it sounds like you only serving your Haitian community. Some people will feel that way. I want to make it like broader and larger to everyone that I am a servant to every Brocktonian.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, I'm part of the organization as a Haitian Community Partners, but I want to be a servant for everybody.
What's your inspiration to be a public servant? You talked about service to God,
mm-hmm.
because you're involved with the church, service with the two Haitian organizations and other things,
yeah.
service with the police department.
Yes.
What drives you to service?
What drives me to service, like I said, once you're a servant, you have to serve. You have to serve. That means there's something going on in Brockton, and I think I can bring some new idea. For example, let me tell you. Some people are even scared to send their kids to the playground to play. Safety issue. We're not talking about only shooting, but we're talking about drug addicts people. They took our parks or playgrounds. When they finish to inject themselves, whatever they take it, they just drop the needle, they send on the ground. Your little baby come and play. He take a little toy. Might take that syringe and stab themselves, and they will catch any type of disease.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we need to put eyes on the situation. We're not gonna change it completely, but we can control it. Mm-hmm. I think that's too much. I'm tired of it. That's why I don't wanna be like everybody complain about it. I want to bring change to it. I want to do actions.
Do you think we have enough resources with the police department to police the city, to stop the crime? It's a big issue. We hear about it all the time. We've had a lot of shell casings around the city this particular summer. What do you think about the crime issue, and what would you do to be part of the solution?
As a former police officer, I'm going to tell you, Mark. Yes, we need more police officers in Brockton. And I'm going to tell you, as Asian, I think we don't have any... enough bilingual police officers. We have two right now, Detective Nazir and Jean, and the mayor said there are two more. There are two more in the academy right now. We're gonna make it four. But yes, we need police officers, but we can use the 170-something that we have to respond to the crime. I don't think the strategies they're using is working. So now I see some police officer in food. Yes, we need community policing. Mm-hmm. We need that. Before you even call the police officer, it was already there for you. So there is an interaction, there is a friendship with the police officer and the civilian. That's what happened. Sometimes a crime happened in special area. By the time the police officer come, the intruder already flee the scene. And sometimes people see and they don't want to talk because they don't have a good friendship with the police officers. But if you have community policing, you know the person, the police officer. The police officer know the resident. They always talking. The kids know them. There's a relationship between them. I think it would be much better to solve a crime because they will see and they will tell them. And that's why we need to bilingual. Because let's say I'm Haitian. If I have somebody like who wasn't speaking any Haitian Creole, the police officer approached that person, there's a barrier. But if he was a Haitian officer, it would be more easy to give some type of description about the person who committed the crime. So having said that, I will advocate to have more police officers and to have community policing. We need that in Brockton.
Now, we have to pay for that. And right now, the city council on Monday night, I don't want to date this too much, but they talked about putting what's called a Proposition 2.5 override on the ballot to fund a fire engine, or a ladder truck, to fund new voting machines, to fund police vehicles. And I don't think it's for staffing. How do you feel about an override of the taxes, which would be more taxes on the residents and taxpayers of Brockton? What do you think about that as a citizen of the community and a candidate?
You know, Mark, that's a very big issue, and that need to talk. And I think people need to go to the chamber and to voice their opinion. Yes, we need more police officers. But if you can, you know what? The reason why we have all that situation, we don't have a safe Brockton. If Brockton is not safe, no business will come to invest in Brockton. Therefore, me and you, who's listening or watching right now, they're going to charge you more taxes to pay for that. So I believe they should tackle first the safety of Brockton, to clean Brockton, and then Brockton will be attracted to investors to come to invest in Brockton. But put the burden of on the citizen to pay more taxes, I don't think it's good. Mm-hmm. I don't think it's good.
So if right now the council has to decide to whether or not to put it on the ballot, and let's say you're the city councilor and you have to make that decision, would you...
I will definitely put it on the ballot. Let people decide. Mm-hmm. The people voted, the elected, the official. Some, yes, we have to make decisions sometimes for them, but in an issue like that, give them a chance to voice the opinion. Let them decide, you know, exactly which way will they go, because as a city councilor, if I make the decision and it's not working, they're going to blame me, and they're not going to vote for me anymore. But if you give them a chance to vote on it, I think that's the best way they should go with it.
Now, there's a lot of big issues going on right now.
Okay.
Big issues that are going on are like the desalinization plant, the water plant.
Yeah.
The mayor wants to buy the water plant. He wants to pay a certain price for it. I keep getting confused on all the numbers, so I won't get into specifics on the numbers. How do you feel about that? We've been paying to lease the plant, to give them payments for the water, but now the mayor thinks it's going to save money to buy the plant. What do you think?
I'm not an expert in that. That's why I have few people. I'm doing a few researches, but I have few people as well that's working with me to know exactly what it's all about. Because I don't want to say anything here to look like I'm not educated enough to voice my opinion on it. I'm still doing my research. I have a lot of this, like you. Some people give me the good side. Some people give me the bad side of it. I have an expert that I can trust that's working with me to get me more educated. And I bet you by the time I come back for the debate in September 9th, I will have a better answer for that.
Okay.
Because I'm doing my research. When I say something, I want to make sure that is accurate and people can take it to the back.
Now, we also talked off camera at another point, I think either over the phone or in person, about the power plant.
Yeah.
do you have an opinion? I know you said you were going to do some more research and be more educated about that.
Exactly.
Do you have a position one way or the other?
All I know about the power plant, all I heard about it, that it's going to bring, some people say it's going to be more resources for Brockton, and some people say it's going to pollute the air. If your child is asthmatic, that's what it can cause. Again, like I said, I do some research on it, and I'm trying to find out what the EPA said about the level of the pollutions. So now I don't know the level of pollution you're going to bring. So like I said, Mark, I don't want to say something to look an idiot, so I should be more prepared to talk about it because I'm doing my research, and this guy, I trust him, is a specialist in that matters. He showed me the good side, he showed me the bad side, and now I'm doing some research on EPA. Is EPA allowed that to happen in Brockton? If they're right, if they're wrong, because EPA, that's they control the air pollutions.
Right.
So I don't think this is not good for Brockton. I believe EPA is going to come and say, oh, the air pollution is going to be in that level. It's not good for a city like Brockton. So I'm doing all my research. By September 9th at the debate, I will have a good shot for you, Mark.
Okay, there you go. Now, let me ask you.
Sure, go ahead.
Right now, there seems to be a lot of animosity between the city council and the mayor.
Yes.
From what I know about you and since I met you, you get along with a lot of people.
Yes.
What do you think about that? Do you think you could be helpful in making, you know, people work more together, getting along, you know, working for the good of the city?
Definitely, Mike, because people who vote for us do not vote to divide it. They wanted to work together for the benefits of the city. When there is no good relationship between the mayor and the city councilor, it's not good. Who's going to pay the price? Is the Brockton, the resident of Brockton, because they still get paid, the mayor get paid, the city council get paid, and the resident, the only that they're doing, vote for them and pay high taxes. Nothing has not been done because there is not a good relationship between them. That needs to stop. It needs to stop. We are one Brockton and one Brockton, one community. We need to work the issue. Mm-hmm. We have to work on an issue for the benefits of Brockton, not for the benefit of myself, not for the benefit of the mayor, not for the benefit of any other city councilor. We need to work together. What is good for the city? The mayor is the mayor, the city councilor, both group got elected. Therefore, they need to work together to stop making people suffer. Mm-hmm. If you keep on fighting, we cannot come a good conclusion. The city is suffering. We got shooting every day. We need to tackle those issues. We got the school department cutting teachers, cutting after school program. Single mother are suffering, and you guys are fighting instead of working together to bring solution. It doesn't make any sense. Yes, I will be a good asset for the city councilors because I'm going to work with everybody. I can work with everybody for the benefits of the city. Not for my benefits, for my children, your children, everybody. But not to fight. It's not good.
Now let's talk about the schools.
Yes.
The kids who are in the school.
Yes.
You're a public education supporter. The city council deals with what they call the city side. Mm-hmm. I always hear that. And then there's the school side. I like to say there's one side. There shouldn't be more than one.
That's okay? Correct.
But how do you see your role? You're not on the school committee. You're on the city council.
Yeah.
The mayor submits the budget. You can cut it.
Yeah.
You can't add to it or move things around. How do you feel that the city councilors should deal with the school committee and the schools?
There should be a partnership. Bring the budget to the city councilor. Cut where you need to cut and cut and paste, add. That's how we're doing. Because my issue is, Mark, too many programs get cut. And that's why if you cut it after school program, for instance, no sports, what the kids going to be doing? They're going to go in the street. When they get in the street, they're going to get they probably get shot because their parents are not here. Their parents are at work. They're going to go outside. Because if we don't keep them busy, they're going to keep us busy in a bad way. So I think the school committee and the city council should work together. Look where their money is for the benefits of our children, because they are the future of the city. We cannot punish them because we cannot get a loan. The school committee and the city council cannot get a loan, and their kids are paying the price. That's exactly what happened. Bring the budget. When they bring me the budget, I'm going to go line by line, because I'm tired for the administration getting raised and teacher getting caught, getting a pink slip, while the administration people get a raise, and you send the teachers home. No substitute teacher. Mm-hmm. No after-school program, no sports, and the money goes where? To the administration. How will balance the budget for the benefits of the city of Brockton?
What issues do you have that you want to talk about specifically? I don't want to talk about all the issues. What, you know, on your literature or on your website, which you can feel free to share with the viewers?
My pen is, I'm tired to see Brockton in the front page of Enterprise of the shooting. Mm-hmm. Shooting drug. Why is drug? That is illegal gun. And most of those people don't come from Brockton. They come from out of town, they come to Brockton. We need to tell them Brockton doesn't have place for them. We can do it. We're not going to solve it in one day, but we can control the situation, Mark. I'm tired of saying, every time you open an enterprise, Brockton, nothing good. A shooting, a drug addict, shooting, cocaine, come on. And I think if we can talk to the justice system as well, I think they're not being fair. When you get a drug dealer, they need to go to jail. Not bail them for $50,000 because they have the money. Mm-hmm. They have the money to bail themselves out. The police officer arrests this guy now in the morning. By 4 o'clock, he's already in the street again. It's a danger for the police officer as well. Mm-hmm. We need to stop. We need to advocate, to tell the judges to be tougher on them. Keep him to jail. However, some drug addicts, don't believe to jail. They belong to treatment. We need to have more treatment place for them in Brockton. That's my main concern. If you want to give the resume, is the public safety, drug treatment, and school. We need those two. If we have those three, we manage to have them. My belief. The education about drugs should start in school as a curriculum. The same way they do it when the kids turn to adolescent, like puberty, the teacher have the special class for them because I sign my son's slip because they want to talk about this issue. They need to educate them about prescription drug abuse. Mm-hmm. That's how I started, prescription drug. They need to see it as a curriculum to educate those people since in school. Maybe we'll have a better chance not to get them involved when you get to high school, because believe it or not, it starts at middle school. Mm-hmm. That's my main priority. It's public safety. If you have public safety in the city, every good thing will come.
Okay, sounds like a plan. Now, I've seen quite a few signs around the city. You've been out meeting people, shaking their hands, knocking on their doors, talking to residents. What are the residents telling you? Similar to what you're talking about?
a funny thing, many residents I met, you know what they said? It's about time to have new blood. It's always old school people, same people over and over. They're not doing anything. I'm just saying what they say. It's not what I said.
Right.
But that's what I get. They say, well, it's about time to have other faces in the government to fight for the city. Because they love city. Some of them don't want to leave the city. Some of them were born in the city, they want to live, but sometimes they feel like they're not home anymore. Too much happened. That's why they said to me, they can't wait to vote for me. That's why they can't wait to vote for me.
And where did you end up on the ballot? What number?
Five.
Okay.
Five. I'm in fifth position.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And there, in the preliminary election, there are 13 candidates for Councillor-At-Large. 8 will go from September 22nd to November 3rd.
Yes.
8 will go on. But being number 5 is a good placement.
That's why it is. And I thank God for that. But you know what? It's number 5, okay?
Yeah.
But when you see 5, you see one hand.
Yeah.
That means that thing going to be working for them. That hand will never tire. Five. Those five fingers, they will always working for the city of Brockton. When you see when you see the fifth people in the fifth place, Adius Pierre, vote for it because this hand going to be working.
There you go. Now, if people want to get in touch with you, get involved in your campaign, help you out, how would they do that? Do you have a Facebook, a website, all of that?
Oh, yes. I have everything set up. They can check my website, www.electadiuspierre.com. They can search, go to the search engine, type Adius Pierre, elect Adius Pierre. It will pop up to their Facebook. Mm-hmm. And they can also call me. My phone number is 774-263-1100. And I have a number for my campaign too. 508-470-1114. 508-470-1114. Call me anytime. I'm willing to sit and talk with you. Let's have a coffee. Let's talk. Because we all are Brocktonians and we're here to stay. We're not going anywhere. We need to fight for our city. I'm not going anywhere.
Now, in order to run for this office,
yeah,
you have a job.
Yes.
You have a family.
Yes.
How do you balance that? Because it's citywide. Citywide is intense. When I've run in a district,
yeah,
or I ran in all of Plymouth County, which is pretty
yes,
tough.
Yes.
But how do you balance that?
That's why you call a goal. When you have a goal, as a servant, I'm never tired to serve my people. Never tired. I manage my family. I have time to manage my job, and I find time to do my campaign as well. So because I want to serve them, that's what I've been doing all my life. I'm a servant. I'm here to serve them. So if I'm tired now, what about when I become a city councilor? I believe there's more work to be done. And we get different people, different opinions, different personality. If I cannot take it now, I cannot take it when I become a city councilor.
Well, you get a smile, like a million-dollar smile. So here's the thing.
Yes.
I just got the three-minute cue.
Yes.
I'm going to give you 2 minutes to talk to the voters, tell them why they should elect you city councillor-at-large.
Yes. From the beginning, I said for those of you, maybe you already knew me, and some people, it's the first time that you see my face. You might see my sign in the street, but the first time that you see my face. Vote for me in September 22nd. You know why? Because I love the city. I'm a fighter. I believe in working as a team because one person cannot solve the problem. I know I am the underdog in that election because we got three more incumbents that coming. But you know what? They've been there. You see what they're doing. I'm the new one. Give me a chance. I will work with you. I will work for you, not working against you. Because Brockton is a city of diversity. And I believe we all must be represented in the government, and we have one Brockton. Let me tell you, once something bad happened in Brockton, it doesn't affect only my family, it affects your family, everybody. So let's solve it. And when you solve that problem, I don't solve it only for my family, it's solved for everybody in Brockton. Because as a Brocktonian, we need to be there for one another. I'm tired of people that complaining. I want to be part of the solution. And if you give me your vote on September 22nd, I will fight for you until I get the job done. I will never take a break when you come to Brockton because I'm your servant, and give me a chance. All I'm asking, give me a chance. Try me. And after you give me that chance, you're going to give me two more chances because you're going to keep voting for me. Because I'm honest. Integrity is my goal. So maybe you want to call me Adius Pierre. Some people call me Mr. Pierre. But I would love you to call me Mr. Integrity because I am the change that you need, the voice you deserve. So remember to vote September 22nd. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Adius.
Thank you, Mark. I appreciate that.
Nice to see you. You're watching Democratically Speaking. Mark Linde, your host. Stay tuned for more candidates in this upcoming election. And most of all, remember to get out and vote.